God.
I've been working these birds for 2 hours.
Are those the ones across the tracks, you think?
No.
Oh, no shit.
I was just about to leave. I was gonna go, because I haven't made it to the hollow yet. And I went behind me to walk the 20 yards back and was calling. And I come back and sit down, and as soon as I sat down, I heard hen that was to the left called. There's still freaking gobblers right there. Make sure I was recording. I'm so jazzed up right now. It's May 12th. I got up like 8:35. I've been working a bird right across the hollow for 2 hours. And I just did a sequence of calling where I was walking away from him, act like I was leaving. And as soon as I come back to sit down, a hen brought 2 gobblers right into me. And I just got a nice 2-year-old. He's gorgeous. I've been hunting so hard. I have barely even heard a gobbler this season. And today I heard probably 300 gobblers. I called him a Jake right off the bat. Hello. Nuh-uh. That's wild. Okay, there's still gobbling here. Yeah. Thank you. Bye. The 410 strikes again. Oh. Absolutely gorgeous bird. Oh man, just gorgeous. Oh man. Probably a 9-inch beard. Three-quarter spurs. It just gets me worked up. Well, son, it don't get any better than this. I hope the film turned out okay. It's probably just the back of my freaking head. But they came in straight behind me. They were above me. I'm on a side, as you can see, I'm some pretty big country. And it's literally just straight up and down. Like, I was, the setup I had, it was horrible. Absolutely horrible. I was kneeling, leaning against two little trees because it's so steep I can't sit against the tree. I made this necklace. It's a bear claw turkey spur necklace from stuff, from animals I've harvested. And I thought it was bad luck, because I have struggled in Virginia. Went to my first out of state hunt, caught in a gorgeous big gobbler. Couldn't get a shot. First day of PA season, had a good bird coming behind me, couldn't get a shot. But I got my first one done. I was starting to have some major doubts. This year's been so bad for everybody I know. Oh, man. Yo, 410, that's gonna be number 9. TSS, baby. Smells like success. So I'll give you guys a little rundown of the whole hunt here. I got here at like 6:30. I got in a little late, but I've been working. I think I might have already. I got here at like 6:30, working this bridge for 2 hours. But my setup was just horrible. This is where I set up. The fruit's all up right there. I just leaned against that little tree going forwards, which is horrible. And the Jake I called in this morning, and it kept going down the hill. The Jake came up over here. The gobbler's been right there by that pine tree gobbler. And I was expecting to come where the Jake did. So I wait in the room, and then I did that sequence. And then, I don't know, hopefully you guys can see it. But these birds come up from behind me, they're up on top. Look how steep this is. The camera might not do enough justice. But this is freaking straight up and down. And the hen popped up right here, come right down the tram road, and she was standing right there at 15 yards. And those gobblers stood right there and hear them gobbling in the video. They were right there, spitting and drumming at like 40 yards. And they cut down behind that tree, and they went behind that bank. And they popped out right here, and I started putting at that gobbler stop, and that's right where he was. It was right there. And I stepped it off, and it's a little over 30 yards. The second Thursday of the season. This is one of the worst seasons I've ever had so far, but it only takes one day to change all of that. Got the old stogie box here. Boy, I've been waiting to smoke one of these. Gonna taste good. My good buddy, Tom Coral, gifted me this, and I told him I'd save it for my turkey, and here I am smoking it. And what a better time to be smoking a stogie. It's not much better than that. Oh, thank you, my friend.